Hello everyone and welcome to this Victron Energy product tutorial. In this product tutorial we're going to have a look at the Victron Energy BMV 600 series battery monitors. We're going to go through their importance in terms of how they can be useful in terms of monitoring a battery bank. We'll go through the installation, the physical installation into a panel, and then show you how to connect it up to a battery. There's one small little bit of configuration that you need to do to get yourself up and running on the system. So let's talk about, for one, the importance of a battery monitor. For one, these battery monitors can automatically pick up the voltage of a battery system. They can give you the time to go in terms of the energy left or stored in your battery, the amp hours in and out. They also store historical data, which can be very useful, and in fact Victron Energy have an additional optional cable and software which can allow you to download that data and view it on your PC. Battery monitors are very useful because you can see the state of your battery, and if you have made a large investment in a battery bank, it can be a small insurance to ensure that you don't overuse your battery to extend the life range into many years. Overusing your battery can potentially shorten the lifespan and write it off if you're not careful. There are two battery monitors in this BMV series. There is the 600S and the 602S. The difference between the two is that the 602S can monitor the voltage of a second battery or battery bank. So let's have a quick look at what comes in the retail package and the installation. Right, so this is the retail packaging in which you'll receive your Victron Energy battery monitor. As you can see, it comes with a battery monitor, a bezel for the installation, which is optional. You have a current shunt. It is configured to work with the current shunt provided, but you can configure it to work with other current shunts. You then have that little red piece of wire over there, which connects to the battery to both power it and pick up the voltage. You then have this nice long gray cable with RJ12 connectors to actually connect to the battery monitor itself. On the back of the box, you do have a picture detailing the installation. As you can see here, it's connected up to the battery, and as I mentioned before, the 602S can be connected up to a second battery to monitor the voltage of a second battery. Just note that Victron Energy, once you remove the monitor from the box itself, Victron Energy underneath in the tray do provide a nice comprehensive set of installation instructions. I suggest you do follow them because they do certainly give you a good guide on how to install the meter inside a box or a panel. So here I'm just demonstrating what the complete installation looks like. If you install it correctly, you should have it nice and flush with the bezel if you do use the bezel as an installation option. At the back you can see there is a white plate behind that bezel which has self-tapping screws which go through the front plate to mount it securely. You can also mount it without the bezel using this nice securing ring on the back into a panel itself. On the back of the meter itself, we have a little piezo speaker which can be configured to alert for certain alarm conditions, or it can be disabled. We have the RJ12 connector where that cable goes into. We have this connector over here which acts as a contact relay. And then we have this connector down here which can be used to download the data to a PC. You do get this optional cable with software from Victron Energy which can be used for that purpose. Right, now that we've got our battery monitor mounted in a panel or a box, we can start the actual installation itself. The grey cable with the RJ12 connector simply connects into that connector on the back of the battery monitor itself. The next part of the installation is to install the current shunt on the negative cables of the battery. This must be done before you connect the battery. The battery is only connected last, so certainly don't have the battery connected when you install the shunt. This is the shunt that comes with the 600S model. As you can see, it's got a single connection point here to monitor one battery, whereas the one for the 602S has got two. The important thing to note here that is on the shunt, it clearly states that the one side is connected to the battery and the other side is to your load or to your inverter. So in my installation, this is obviously flicked up that way. So this side goes down to the battery, this side is going up to the inverter, and that's obviously on your negative side of the battery. Next we have this red cable which is provided in the with the battery monitor, which has got a little ring which gets connected to the positive terminal of the battery, and this little connection here which goes into the current shunt itself. So that, I'll demonstrate how that goes in. To install this connector, all you need is a flat screwdriver. You gently push down on this orange connection here and slide the cable into the top and release, and then it's installed securely. Right, the last part of the installation is to the battery itself. Now my battery is already connected up, but it's good practice always to connect your positive lead to your battery first and then your negative. But you put your big thick battery cable onto your terminal first and then the thin ring connector. So this ring connector, which comes from the current shunt itself, goes on after you've placed your big thick battery cable onto your terminal, and then it's secured tightly. Once you have your battery cables firmly connected to your battery terminals, you can then connect the other end of the grey cable with the RJ12 connector into the shunt itself. Once you've gone and connected that RJ12 connector into the actual current shunt itself, you'll see that the battery monitor fires up and will actually display the model number on the display. It will then come up and display the voltage of the battery itself. Now these battery monitors are set to auto detect the voltage of the battery system. So if you've got a 12, 24, 48 volt system, it should automatically detect that and it'll come up on the display. The last task is just to configure the battery capacity. That's done very straightforward. As you can see on the front of this display here, we have these buttons as set up, a plus and minus for selecting things, and then the select button. So we hold the setup button for a couple of seconds, you then go into the setup mode. The first setting you get is the capacity in ampere of the battery itself. To make any changes there, you merely push the select button and it starts selecting the individual digits that you can change. So you push it again to get to the digit that you need to. Say if this was a 105 amp hour battery, I could go and then select here. Use the minus to take it down to zero, select, use the positive button to go and select the 5. Then once that's done, once you're happy you've got the setting done, you merely push the setup button, which stops the flashing state and sets it, and then to get back to the main display screen, you just hold the setup button again for about 2 seconds. Right, you're now almost ready to use your battery monitor. The first screen here shows the current voltage of the battery. You can flick through these screens using the plus or minus. So if you go down, the next one shows the current, which shows the current going into the battery or being consumed out of the battery. The next screen is the consumed energy, and this displays the amount of amp hour consumed from the battery. A fully charged battery sets this readout to about 0 amp hour when it's synchronized. And then if a current is being drawn, you'll actually see it being removed from here. Now, to set this up correctly from the start, you want to have your battery fully charged and hopefully it's a new battery. We can then manually synchronize this to get you started. It will automatically set itself up, but I'll show you how to set that to synchronize manually. The next screen is the state of charge, and as you can see, that is also waiting to be synchronized. Now, the state of charge, this is the best way to monitor the actual state of the battery. This readout represents the current amount of energy left in the battery. So a fully charged battery will be represented by 100%, and a fully discharged battery will be represented by 0%. We then have the time to go display, and this is an estimation of how long the battery can support the present load until it needs a recharge. So right, so if we come back, we come back to the voltage screen to now manually synchronize your battery, and as I said, remember that your battery should be fully charged and new. We just merely hold the plus and the minus down together for about 2 seconds. There we go. And you can see it's come up and it's now set the state of charge to 100%. Your time to go is set to infinity because there's been no load coming out of the battery currently. And you can see your consumed energy is sitting at 0 amp hour because we are back at full charge. Thanks very much for watching this Victron Energy product tutorial on the BMV600 series battery monitor. In part 2 of this series, we'll go through the more advanced settings of the battery monitor and show you how you can view the log data. Cheers.